Hey guys, my name is Freedom. Today, I'm going to show you how to flip any of the CC3 cloth, like the mirror, how to flip it in just 1 second. So just follow here step by step. First, you are in Character Creator 3, what we call CC3. And now, I'm going to drag in one of my CC3 projects and replace all. Just wait for a while. It is loading one of the avatar that I already designed. Alright, now you can see it is already finished loaded. And this avatar, look at this cloth. I want to flip it like a mirror image, like this. Just to flip it over from left to the right. And this is just a cloth. If I want to flip it, I must make it become the T-pose. That's the first step. Click here, click template, click motion, and drag in the T-pose or double click it. Now this avatar already in T-pose. Next, what we are going to do is press Q or just go to the scene to select the ones. This is a camisole. I want to flip it over. I must click here, and then convert it to accessory. Bake current shape, this is very important. You must choose bake current shape, and then click convert. Now, it is already become accessory. Next, you have to open your icon, let it on. And from CC3 here, from the character creator tree, you click here, send the character to icon. And then, in icon, you need to wait for a while. It is loading your avatar. All right, now you can see this avatar. It is already loaded. Now, what you need to do is, you must always know that this is the accessory. So you press Q and double click to select it. This is the accessory. Click modify, click here and drag down. The accessory is something that attached to part of the body. So now you just need to click detach, and now this object already free, already independent. So you scroll up, click edit in 3D exchange. Now it will automatically send to 3D exchange now. All right, you can see this is a 3D exchange. The location won't be changed. From here, you export it out. Export on your desktop here. Click File, Export. Sorry, not here. You export as FBX file. Here, you choose Maya 32-bit. Must make sure include geometry and select all. Embed the texture. And I'm going to create a new folder here. I will name it as Cloth 01. All right, I will export it in Cloth 01 folder. I copy the folder destination, Control C to copy, and then here, select all, Control A, Control V to paste here. Next, I click OK, and click OK. Now, it will export it as FBX file. Click OK. Now, name it properly, press F2, Cloth 01. This is the original, the FBX file. Now, I want to show you how to flip it in just 1 second. To flip it in just 1 second, the software that you need is the Autodesk Maya. What you need to do is just drag in the FBX file into here, drag in into the Maya, and now it is already in your Maya. Now, click here to turn on the texture. You can see, in order to flip it, you must click and select it. Then you should be able to see this part. So what you need to do is, just to find it out, the scale X, you click here, 0.876. This is the one. You click it and you add a negative or minus. You add a minus. Now it becomes minus 0.876, or we call it negative 0.7876. This number, you just need to put negative and press enter. Now you can see it is totally completely flip over. Now, this completely flip over, and now what you need to do is just export it out as FBX file. It's here. Click file, export all, and then copy this folder destination, Control C to copy, and click here, Control A, Control V to paste, and press enter. Then, at here, the file name, you just need to put clove01_flip. Then, click export all. Now, this is how are we going to flip. This is the FBX file that we want. So next, in your iClone, iClone 7, here, this one, you just need to press delete button to delete it. Now, next, what you need to do is just drag in the clove01 flip, drag in into the iClone, and release your mouse. Now, you can see it is already in your iClone. It is already on your avatar, but the texture is something wrong. So what you need to do is just come here, and then you can ignore everything first, but from your character creator tree, what you need to do is go to the UV, this part, the shader type is PBR, so now you click here, save all the material texture. Save it first, save on the desktop, the same folder, right click, new folder, name it as material. So double click in and select this folder. Now you check back under the material folder, all of this already in. So now we back to the iClone. You can just temporarily ignore of this first. Now it is already selected, right? You see, under the scenes, it is a prop. So what you need to do is just click here, under the modified, click here. You scroll down, go to find attach. Pick the parents and attach to this avatar. Now it is attached to CC base spine02. Now it's okay already. Then you click and select the avatar. Then click here, scroll up, edit in character creator, click here. And now in your character creator, the current project will be discarded. Do you like to save? You click no. Don't save the previous one and click replace all, click OK. Now just wait for a while until it finishes loading. Now you can see it is already in your character creator tree. And then, this is just an accessory, the clove01 flip. What you are going to do is just make it become a clove. Click here, click transfer skin width, and then template, you choose the clove, and click OK, apply. Now you can see it applied as a clove. You can close this already and go to the UV here. It should be PBR, but it doesn't matter. You scroll down the strength, make it become 100. So now you can see it is already completely flipped over. It is just like my picture just now. At the beginning, this cross is at left hand side, now it already become right hand side. The whole geometry, the whole 3D object, the whole cloth's 3D mesh will be flipped over like a mirror. And then now you can see this one already become a cloth. So what I'm going to do is to save this so that I can use it in future. So click content. Of course you can see something wrong here. This one is very easy to settle. Click here, click conform, click calculate collision, and click here, wait. Click confirm again. Then click edit mesh, and you can just edit from here the sculpt. Just make it up. All right. So now, for this time, you want to make it up the strength. for this time cannot. So you must do from another side. Okay, so once you flip already, actually you cannot sculpt it as normal. Before you flip it, you can sculpt. So now this is a new discovery. You cannot use this tool. But never mind. Now I show you how to save it first. Okay. In order to save it, you click the contents, you click here, and then you click the custom. It is under the shirt here. You click plus. Now you will save it as cloth 01. Flip. Next time, if you press delete button to delete it. All right. Now it is still under the edit mesh. Now, double click. Go to the scenes. Select the cloth 01. Flip. You delete it. So next time, if you want to do it again, you still can come back to the content here, the cloth 01 flip. You can just double click. It will automatically apply. Now, this is a new cloth. All right. So now you can see this is a whole process on how to flip. And then how about all the PBR things? You can just come back to here next. You click here, load all the material, because just now you already saved everything. Now some of the map loss, you can just load all from the same location under the desktop, cloth 01, under the material, you click select folder. Now everything will be loaded back, and now it is in PBR already. It is definitely PBR, and now the AO map and roughness, the metallic all come back already. All right. That's all for today about how to flip any of the CC3 cloth in just 1 second in Autodesk Maya and import back into CC3, into Character Creator 3. It can flip the whole 3D mesh. So this is an awesome way if you want to modify your cloth and even the hairstyle, anything. All right, that's all for today. Thank you for watching. If you love my video tutorial, if you feel all these tutorials are very helpful to your 3D animation and game developing, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel and also turn on the mini bell and select all so that when next time I publish a new video tutorial, you will receive a notification immediately. See you in my next video. Enjoy, happy animation and game developing. See you.